東京ゲームショー2021オンラインをご覧の皆様、こんばんは。ここからのお時間は505ゲームスの番組をお送りいたします。それではどうぞ。
505ゲームス新
作ファイブオンファイブゲームスニュータイトルショーケース。
さあ、ということで皆さん、こんばんは。東京ゲームショー
2021 So good evening everyone. Welcome to the online program. We are going to hear about 505 games. I'm the MC Kosuke Hiraiwa. We have some guests, but due to restriction of the program, they couldn't come to the venue. So I'm by myself. But instead, we received a video message from the three.
TGS 公式放送をご覧の皆さん、こんにちは。505 Games Japan ジェネラルマネージャーの菅原です。
マーケティングの滝です。
プロデューサーの矢野です。
今日は505 Games の公式放送をご覧いただき本当にありがとうございます。実は私たちも今日はスタジオに雪満々だったんですが、どうしても都合が合わずにスタジオに行くことができません。
いやー、行けなくなっちゃいました。残念です。
はい、本当に残念なんです。なんですけれども、今日は皆さんにお楽しみいただけるようにたくさん情報を持ってきました。会場の平岩さんがバッチリ紹介してくださると思うので、そちらをご覧ください。
505 Games は AAA タイトルからインディーゲームまで幅広いタイトルを数多くパブリッシングしています。
はい、で我々505は今回 TGS 初参加なんです。なので505 Games について皆さんにもっとよく知ってもらうためにムービーを今回作成してまいりました。
はい、では早速そちらをご覧ください。どうぞ。
We were born out of belief. A belief that we can.Belief to innovate and elevate so that the dreamers can dream and the storytellers can weave their tales. The curious can discover, the creators can create, the players can play, and the perfectionists can perfect every last piece. A belief that amazing people can do amazing things, that the underdog can lead the pack, that the diamond in the roughcan shine brightest, that heroes can rise. A belief that we are better together, and that together we can do so much more. So to all those we believe in, thank you for believing in us.As we believe in the future.
さあ、ということでお三方からのビデオメッセージ、そして
So we received a video message and we also watched anniversary trailer for 15 year commemorativevideo, indie games to the AAA games. There are many titles that you are familiar with, I'm sure. So they are commemorating the 15th anniversary. Then we also received some message for representing the
industry. Hello everyone, it's Courtney Hope or Jesse Faden from Control.
五十嵐です。
修太郎です。
池田です。
はい、こんにちは、小島です。
Hi there. I'm Marco, co-founder of Kuno Simulazioni and the creator of the Assetto Corsa franchise.
High five, 505 Games.
百栄雄伝、英雄伝クロニクル。そして、百栄雄伝ライジングを手掛けているラビット&ベアスタジオズ代表、村山義太です。
こんにちは、小島プロダクション、新川洋次です。
Hey guys, this is Tommy Earl Jenkins, aka Die Hardman from Death Stranding.
Hello, this is Joseph Farris. It was quite a while I worked together with 505 on my first game, Brothers, A Tale of Two Sons. And I remember it was a great time. Congrats on 15 years, and I hope you at least get 15 more years. Not more, 15 more, no, I'm kidding. I hope you get 100 more years. Take it easy.
Congratulations on the behalf of everybody at Remedy.
To 505 Games and all of the marvelous people who work there, happy 15th birthday from Infinity Plus 2 here in Australia.
I just wanted to take a moment to wish each and every one of you at 505 Games a very happy 15-year anniversary.
505 Games-san, 15周年 おめでとうございます!
ゴーマルゴさんが この度ですね 15周年迎えたということで 誠におめでとうございます。
Today, on behalf of our entire team in Italy, I would like to congrats with all the 505 teams and family for this great achievement. Staying alive and keeping growing for 15 years in this business is not quite easy, and we know it very well.
Congratulations on your 15th anniversary. All the best wishes from One More Level team here in Poland.
Gomargo Games の 15周年をお祝いいたします。
Happy 15th birthday. May we celebrate many more in the future.
15周年 おめでとうございます。
So, congrats for this great 15 years achievement.
I want to take this time to wish everyone at 505 Games an amazing 15 year anniversary. You guys rock.
Happy birthday, 505 Games.
We received messages from gorgeous members. Because of the restrictions, they couldn't come to the venue. But we will still welcome a designer, producer, and a developer later on in the program. I have some information to share. This is 505 Games Japan Twitter follow campaign. If you follow the official Twitter and retweet it, and five people can win the Steam code. Please scan the QR code on the screen and follow the Twitter, and please add hashtag TGS. Let's look at the lineup for today. We are going to have those titles coming: Legend, Rescue Party Life, Unturned, Growth, Song of Evertree. Those are the titles that we are going to talk about. We are going to also talk about Eiyuden Chronicle and Eiyuden Chronicle Rising with some guests. This is a lineup for today. I'm sure you're interested in lots of the information that we are going to share. First, headline news of 505 Games. I received the information from them. First, this is Re-Legend. This is the main character who lost his memory and encountered many difficulties, but he tries to collect clues of the memories. The communication with the villagers is also fun as part of the game, and this is a multiplayer, allows up to four people to play together. This gameplay is available on Nintendo Now.
Hello everyone at Tokyo Game Show. I'm DC from Magnus Game Studio, which is based in Malaysia. We are also the developer of Re-Legend, a monster taming simulation RPG game. Re-Legend is an action RPG game with anime-inspired visuals. Since me and my brother, we grew up playing a lot of Japanese games and watching a lot of Japanese anime. Some of our favorites are Digimon and Pokemon. I'm super excited to show more of Re-Legend running on Nintendo Switch. Are you ready? ¶¶ Re:Legend can be enjoyed in so many ways, such as the fast-paced action battle system, farming, where you can plant your favorite plants or fruits in different seasons, or monster raising, where you tame and raise the wild magnus to aid you in your adventure, or just simply fishing or mining, and so many more. What's more, you can play Re:Legend in a 4-player co-op multiplayer, so you can bring your friends along to the adventure. I really, really hope players in Japan are looking forward to join the journey to the land of Aethia. Re:Legend will be coming to all platforms in November 2021. Are you ready? Arigatou gozaimasu.
さあ、ということで、Nintendo Switch のプレイ映像初公開となります。
That's the gameplay for the first time to be released for Nintendo Switch and comments from the developers. Next, I'm going to share the release information about the Re:Legend. So this will be available on Steam, Nintendo Switch, PlayStation 4, Xbox One, and slated to be released in November 2021. So 1 month to go, and this can be played by up to 4 people in a multiplayer game. Stay tuned.
Let's look at the game trailer for the titles.
Hello, I'm Nelson. I am the developer of the PC version of Unturned. Yeah, around 9 or 10, I started making games in Game Maker, and Unturned started because I wanted to play the DayZ mod with some of my friends, but most of us didn't own Arma 2 at the time. It feels weird letting others change it, but it has been a great learning experience. Unturned is an online multiplayer survival FPS in a world full of zombies, which is cliche, I know. It also has a strong focus on player versus player combat and base raiding. 60 FPS, 4K, new features and content, faster loading times, and much more development support going forward. Elver really feels different from the other maps. It has a much longer endgame to progress through with tougher zones and NPC trading to unlock, and there are some pretty interesting quest lines in there. In summary, the Unturned Elver DLC is releasing for console editions this October, and the next gen version is coming out this winter.
We watched two trailers. Let's talk about the titles. First, Rescue Party Live, Firefighters, Volunteers, Guide Dogs. You have a variety of teams and cooperate with them and to rescue people's lives in emergency. This is a rescue adventure game. This title becomes available in fall 2021 on Steam. It's joining Steam next fest starting at 26 o'clock on October 1st as well. Please check it. Next title is this, Unturned. You are surrounded by zombies and you have to survive. This is an open world survival sandbox game. You can already play this on PS4 and Xbox One overseas, but we are going to release it with a platform of PS4, PS5, Xbox One, Xbox Series X and S in Japan in winter.
Once upon a time, our lands teemed with creatures great and small. The beauty of the worlds was unrivaled. The people thrived and lived.
So next is Grow Son of the Evertree. This game has life management and adventure elements. It's a WordCraft sandbox game. So with Evertrees grow thick, area with a peaceful and a beautiful world, but mysteriously weathered. Everheart Alchemist, you are an offspring and you're going to revibrate this world. And all that was cherished. So it looks like an RPG, but it's actually a sandbox game, so I really look forward to that. And we are going to have a gameplay footage that is going to be released for the first time. Anime made in Abyss and Star Wars Visions, Kevin Penkin were in charge of those music, and we have an interview video of him. Please watch
this. Hi,皆さん, こんにちは. 僕の名前はケビン・ペンキンと申します。 今回、グローオーバーザーエヴェトリーというオサエのインディゲームの作曲家として参加させていただいております。ぜひこのインタビューよろしくお願い申し上げます。I always saw myself as a composer because I had no skill in any other category of study. I actually started out by playing flute, but I eventually graduated to doing compositions. At first in a more classical style, but when I started playing video games when I was 10, I played a game called Metroid Prime from Nintendo, and I loved that game so much that I wanted to do music just like that game. And so that's how I started wanting to write music for video games. When I start writing for whether it be an anime or a game, I always start by trying to write musical ideas that physically depict the environment. So it could be the color palette, it could be the character design, but I always like to try and put the music in the DNA of the project. Obviously, anime and games are different because one is linear, one is interactive. However, that doesn't have any influence on the core musical creative idea. However, at some point, of course, those two paths start deviating, and so it can become very, very different. Well, my first contact with Prideful Sloth was through Cheryl Vance, and she reached out because she actually knew my music from Made in Abyss. I figured that because we both live in Australia, she would be more familiar with my music from a game called Florence, which was an Australian video game that did very well here. However, turns out that she was also a big anime fan, so we got along straight away, and that's where she knew my music from. And so when she was showing me Grow, she had all these wonderful ideas for different parts of this world to have different characteristics, which is something I'm very, very, very passionate about from a musical perspective. And so our conversations started straight away in a very, very excited manner, and we were able to have a very, very, very healthy creative conversation about what we wanted the music of Grow to sound like. And I did do a little research, and I did want to see where they were coming from when it came to how Grow was progressing from Yonder. However, I didn't want to go too deep purely because I did want to treat this as a new game. I was also a new staff member, so I didn't want to kind of step on anyone's toes. I just wanted to kind of really do a new and honest thing for this game. Because Grow is quite a unique world with a lot of variety, there was a few different ideas that really sort of became the core of Grow. One of them was to do with how instruments were selected and what instruments would be associated with different parts of the world and different biomes, etc. Also, just being able to maybe occasionally use some very specific and unique guest instruments such as soprano saxophone or kazoo or something like that was a really fun sort of breath of fresh air when writing, you know, quite a large soundtrack actually. Thank you so much for listening to this interview. It was a great pleasure to be part of Grow Song of the Evertree as its composer. And it'll be out on Steam, it'll be out on Switch, and it'll be out on PlayStation 4, among other things, in the near future. So thank you for your patience while we finish up this incredible game. And of course, stay safe, stay healthy, and hopefully see you soon. Bye for now.
Grow, Song of the Evertree.
So for the first time released, we just watched the interview of Kevin, and so that's the Grow Son of the Evertree will be out on PC, Steam, PlayStation 4, Xbox One, Nintendo Switch, and is slated to be released on November 16, 2021. And on Steam page, with the more numbers to be added to your wish list, you will have a more discount. So please add this to your wish list and get the newest information on Grow Son of the Evertree. Next, moving on to GT racing simulation game Assetto Corsa Competizione, where 505 Games is a global publisher. So there's a footage, and on YouTube, with incredible driving technique and being viewed for 3.78 million times, a video by a 93 years old grandpa. Do you know about him? And this video triggered Assetto Corsa Competizione's development studio Kronos Simulazioni, and we have a deal, and they send DLC code and original gift to him. And unfortunately, he died on August 19th, where we were supposed to have some message for him, from him on this TGS. But we got some message video from his grandson. So please watch this.
の大きな箱なんですけれども、
お、
何これ、
アセットコルサの帽子ですね。
どうかな、
いいじゃないか、ありがとうございます。
He really seemed to be enjoying the drive-in. I think he overcame a lot of challenges, including his age, and he enjoyed the game. And I think that's the beauty of games, and I'd like to send my condolences to him. So that's all for the headline news for 505 Games. Let's move on to the next segment.
The latest information about Eiyuden Chronicle and Eiyuden Chronicle Rising. Finally, we have some guests. I'd like to introduce one by one. First, Yoshitaka Murayama, who is the game designer and scenario writer, who's also the head of Rabbit Bear Studios. Studio for Eiyuden Chronicle, which collected more funds than any other project for 2020 Kickstarter's game. Next, Junko Kawano, who designed the characters for both Eiyuden Chronicle and Eiyuden Chronicle Rising. They are also from Genko Suikoden, and they work together. We also have Kunio Natsume. I'm a development producer. Nice to meet you. Also, we have Toshiaki Kaname, Eiyuden Chronicle Development Team. I was alone for so long. You're working hard. I wanted you to join me earlier in the program. Eiyuden Chronicle and Eiyuden Chronicle Rising. What can we hear from you? We brought a video. Let's watch it together. We just watched a video. Yes. We're making RPG title called Eiyuden Chronicle. But Eiyuden Chronicle Rising was what we watched. This is a spin-off. This is an action RPG trailer. So, Eiyuden Chronicle is RPG, but the Rising is more towards action. Yes, it is action RPG, but this is a spin-off of Eiyuden Chronicle. So those who play RPG can still enjoy Rising. And Suzuki-san, what do you think? If we we always welcome your feedback so that the RPG users can still enjoy the game. People are worried about it on YouTube, but you are working with Natsume Atari. We started Eiyuden Chronicle as a Kickstarter. Usually, half year before the launch, we announce it. However, this is a Kickstarter. In last year, we already announced it. So the launch was very far ahead. And in between, we have lots of time. We decided to do something about to fill in the gap. Bloodstained in the Pompanion game. And Igarashi-san was playing it, so I thought maybe I can copy the same concept so that we can buy some time. And we tried to find a company who can work with us, and we spotted Natsume Atari. We always trusted them. If they can work with us, then that'll be great. That is the start of the collaboration. As we watched in the video, Eiyuden Chronicle Rising was done by Tadashi Satomi, who wrote a scenario for Persona by UB True Mind and Persona Innocent Sin and Eternal Punishment. We are old friends. We go out for a drink. Very casual relationship. We cannot do it these days, but we used to go out for a drink. We both like wine, and he brings good wine. And I drink it a lot. And he said it's kind of a waste that when I drink it. Eiyuden Chronicle is RPG, and it's an important title, so when you think about spin-off of that, I wanted to pick a partner who we can trust the most, and they accepted our offer. So you solidified your foundation for your development. Tadashi Satomi-san couldn't come to this venue. If you have anything related to the titles, I want to hear more about it. This is all-round continent. This is called the New Never Village, and it's at the frontier of an all-round continent. And the Galdia Empire and the association of small countries are fighting each other. And it's located on a volcanic belt, and there's a cold area near it. And there's an earthquake a couple of months ago, and because of the ancient ruins buried underground, there are many adventurers and merchants came to gain fortunes. And all of a sudden, this small village became lively. So Lorenz and sorcery lenses are the key, and everyone tries to find those Lorenz. Rising is kind of an introduction to Eiyuden Chronicle.
まあ、設定的にも、窓レンズという設定
The setting of the sorcery lens of Lawrence is very important. And I talked to Satomi-san about it. And maybe Western movie would be good, he said. So we didn't really agree to one idea at the beginning. Redemption, maybe we talked about. So those elements are all in the world. And what is the story? Story, ancient ruins and ruins are the keys. Main characters try to find ancient ruins, but they also try to find the people suffering financially from the restoration of the earthquake. So they, even if they are against the excavation of the ancient ruins, they also try to cooperate. And there's a secret buried, and this secret is related to the destiny of one of the characters. And there's also conspiracy ongoing under the surface. So you see some tips of the linkage to Eiyuden Chronicle. Very exciting. Yes, the story is done by Satomi-san, and I was very pleased to see that. Yes, the story is very good. And key art is very nice too. Genre is different. This is action RPG. So I wanted to show the fierce fighting on the drawing. Designs of the characters quite attractive. Kangaroos are maybe a little too small. Sorry about that. Mining. Pickle. Yes. This is climbing wax. A gear for mount climbing. So that's something you should look for. We want to also look at characters. For Rising, there are three main characters, and also we have guest characters from Eiyuden Chronicle. JB, who's proud of exploring the ancient ruins, also Garu and Isha. And they are trying to find ancient ruins, but they become one team. Garu is speedy, Garu is powerful, and Isha is a wizard. And by switching among the three, you can make progress. Please look forward to the treasure that they're going to find in the end. I have a question for Kawano-san. Any highlight of the characters? Garu, he's a middle-aged man. Well, it was difficult to draw Garu. Why Kangaroo? So I went to the zoo first. So you really went to see, actually I saw Warabi. So Kangaroo, Garu looks like he has a bag on the belly. Next. Linked to Eiyuden Chronicle, there are seven guest characters from Eiyuden Chronicle. Madorens is the key of this game's world. And there is conspiracy ongoing behind the scene, which links to Eiyuden Chronicle. Anything else that you can share? As you mentioned, so we wanted to show the characters that you're going to see on Eiyuden Chronicle, there are more than 100 characters on it, but we are going to show 7 of them with Rising. People get together, and this is a spin-off, so we change the characters a little bit, but still express them. So we just want to show the idea that it's linked to Eiyuden Chronicle. They are also on Eiyuden Chronicle as well. Yes.
So the Eiyuden Chronicle Rising, that is packed of appealing points, and we have a gameplay footage from Natsume Atari at the development studio. So this is first time in the world. Please watch this video. So this is an actual gameplay footage. Murayama-san, this is really beautiful, the graphics. Yeah, thank you. It's so-called 2.5D. So in the Eiyuden Chronicle, it has dotted characters, it's 2D. It's very playable, and in addition to that, we also have the cutting-edge graphic technologies fused. So that's the idea we had for the Eiyuden Chronicle, and we wanted to incorporate that in Rising as well to create beautiful graphics. That's what we asked Natsume-san to do, which is now under development. And Suzuki-san, Kawano-san, what do you think? Any comments? What were the challenges in the development? Well, you know, on PC Steam and for PlayStation 5, we really enjoy the production for the graphics, so we don't really think they were challenges, but of course it was hard. And we also try to make it with a lot of action elements so that people can enjoy. Well, thank you for working hard on the games. You know, the light texture is very detailed, the rocks, the lights are really beautiful. Yeah, my request was make this game beautiful, you know? It's a very simple order, but it's not that easy to respond to that order, right? To make it happen, that requires a lot of work. Well, we want to enjoy the process. We also enjoy the process of designing. And we talk about the platform, the characters, you know, you have a lot of opportunities to shift, to transit the characters. Yes, as actions, we think it's more enjoyable if you can change the characters. But for RPG fans, Rabbit Bear, some staff say that maybe we can add some action elements to make it more fun. And so we asked Natsume-san to make something that person will like as well. And we also participated as observers to oversee the production. So we had some requests for Natsume-san for the production. Suzuki-san, what do you think? Yeah, I played the game. It was quite difficult. But still, depending on characters, you can easily change the characters by hitting your console button. So we did a lot of adjustments, so you can be reassured to play it.
So even for RPG fans, you don't need to hesitate to play this game. And look at this stage, it's really real. And in the graphics, we have incorporated a lot of action RPG elements. There is a character called Isha. So she's the leader of a town, and your mission is to revitalize that town, and as a result, your character will get stronger. And the character is going to collect items in a mine. So that's some background, and that is also something we want to showcase here in this video. The effect is also very cool. It's so beautiful. I'm glad that you were impressed by the graphics. Yes, we really asked Natsume-san to make great graphics. So that was Eiyuden Chronicle Rising and Eiyuden Chronicle, and there are some announcements on it. So today we are going to update you the information on the release date of Eiyuden Chronicle Rising and the Eiyuden Chronicle. So Rising will be out on PC, PS4 and 5, Xbox One and XS. And you can also play it with Xbox Game Pass on the day of release. And then this is also new information. Rising will be available for Nintendo Switch as well. So that's been decided, and I think you can certainly enjoy that. It's going to be released at the same time. The release date is slated to be in spring 2022. So then we have another side for the Eiyuden Chronicle, and it's going to be available on multiple platforms, and it is now conducting a survey to see if this can also be released for Nintendo Switch, and the release date is expected to be in 2023. So, since Kickstarter, we also promised to release this game for Nintendo Switch users. So that's what we want to realize. And now we are doing a survey, and we haven't confirmed yet, so I cannot give you a commitment, but we will update information for you as soon as we have more clarity on this. So please stay tuned, and we will have more announcements to come. Murayama-san, over to you. There is a Japanese official account Twitter for Eiyuden Chronicle. We used to have a global official Twitter, but now we opened a Japanese one. So please follow this as well. Thank you. Yeah, please get latest information from this account. And moving on to the last section, I want to ask our guests what they thought about today's program. Well, typhoon is approaching Japan, and despite of that, I enjoyed the talks here, and we also watched a lot of videos, and we really want people to play Rising before they play Eiyuden Chronicle. Yes, Rising is a spin-off, but it, of course, has the spirits of Eiyuden Chronicle. It's packed with the same spirit, so we really want our fans to enjoy. Yeah, please look forward to the game titles. And I want to thank our guests, as well as the guest from Natsume. Thank you very much. So that's the latest information for the Eiyuden Chronicle and Eiyuden Chronicle Rising. And we are now running out of time for this program, and we're going to wrap it up. So that was the showcase for the games and the information. And I hope to see you again somewhere else. Goodbye.
505 Games の番組をお送りいたしました。この後19時よりスクエアエニックスの番組が始まります。 東京ゲームショー2021オンライン、引き続きお楽しみください。